Morning student, today we study the fundamental unit of life, the part 4th video. So part 4, in last class we studied the inbuilt cell, plant cell, what are the functional part of the each cells. So cell membranes, then nucleus, plasma membrane, cell wall, etc. Right? So in this class, we study the subcontinuum part of that animal cell or plant cell. So you watch your diagram of animal cell, plant cell in your textbook. Okay? The first one is the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm, we studied the fourth one is the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is enclosed by a cell membrane. What is cytoplasm? The cytoplasm means this is enclosed by the cell membranes. What are the functions? In the absence of this, the elution of viruses takes place. So when cytoplasm is absent in these cells, the elution of viruses takes place. So the cytoplasm is very important in this cell. So where it located? It is located the enclosure of a cell membrane. So what happened? In habit, they have many cell organelles. So cytoplasm contains a many cell organelles. So what do you mean cell organelles? The cell organelles means they have the component of a cells. The cell have a component structure, small component of cells. So this is called the cell organelles. We studied last class, right? So this is the functions and the introduction of a cytoplasm. That is enough. Next, move on the cell organelles. Cell organelles genta. So we study the component of the cell is called cell organelles. So that means each and every cell contains a cell organelles. What happened? The cell organelles, the function is it activates the cells. What is the function? It activates the cells. So the cell is activated when cell organelles are is present in the cell. Cellularly, cell organelles idre adi avuto activate avuto. They say they have to movement of the cells, then producing energy, then transfer of the materials. These type of functions are occurred in cell, right? So the cell organelles helps to the activation of the cell. What are the structure? It has a bone like structure. So structure of cell organelles, bone. It's a round shape, small rounds. So this is round like structure. Next, what the cell organelles? The cell organelles contains specific so many sub parts like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, lysosome, ribosome, etc. So these type of the parts of cells is contained in cell organelles. So it helps the mitochondria, lysosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, etc. These are helps to it activate cell. They have a certain function. Each and every part has a certain function, right? So it helps to activate. So it helps to the activate these parts of the cells. So cell organelles have so many parts like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, etc. So these are help with certain function. It plays an important role in the to activate the these part of the function. So cell organelles help to activate the cells. So that is that much is enough and is very important. Next, in this cell organelles we study first one is a ER. ER means endoplasmic reticulum. What is endoplasmic reticulum? Endoplasmic reticulum is a large network. It's a large network. It's a very important in the cell organelles. It's one of the cell organelles. So this is a very, it has a large network. What happens? It is a tube and sheet like structure. Either it's a tube or it's like a sheet like structure. So the endoplasmic reticulum is a large network. It has a tube or sheet-like structure. So next, the endoplasmic reticulum are in two types. So there are two types of endoplasmic reticulums are present. What are these? First one is a rough endoplasmic reticulum. First one is rough endoplasmic reticulums. So what are the function of these rough endoplasmic reticulum? The rough endoplasmic reticulum help the manufacture of fats, proteins and lipids. What? The manufacture of a fat, lipid, proteins are manufactured by a rough endoplasmic reticulum. So the endoplasmic reticulum, it helps to build in the cell membrane. The manufactured lipid proteins are helped to build a cell membrane. If a cell membrane is built by the proteins or lipid which are manufactured by the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So we have studied the first one, the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Second one is the the manufacture of the cell building is building of cell is takes place. What we call this process? This process is called as a membrane biogenesis. So membrane biogenesis means the rough endoplasmic reticulum which manufacture the protein, lipid, then fat, protein, lipid, which are manufactured by the rough endoplasmic reticulum, which is helped to a building a cell membrane. To build a cell membrane, such process is called as a membrane biogenesis. So this process all occurred in endoplasmic reticulum, particularly rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, the second one part is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, smooth ER. I write short form smooth ER means smooth endoplasmic reticulum. What is the meaning of this? The smooth endoplasmic reticulum have a perfect functions are there, but the whole endoplasmic reticulum, it helps to transport the material between the cytoplasm and cell and the nucleus. What? The endoplasmic reticulum have functions. What is this? They transport the material from cytoplasm to the nucleus, between the cytoplasm and the nucleus, and we provide the biochemical activity. What is? We provide a chemical, biochemical activity. So the main function of the endoplasmic reticulum is transport the material between the cytoplasm and the nucleus and provide the biochemical activity. So this is the endoplasmic reticulum. Next, move on to the Golgi apparatus. What is this? Golgi apparatus. The name Golgi, which are discovered by Camillo Golgi. He is one of the scientists, the biologist. So Camillo Golgi. The Golgi apparatus, the name is indicates a Camillo Golgi. So he discovered the Golgis. So we named as a Golgi apparatus. So how they look like? The Golgi apparatus are arranged in a parallel. You already see in your textbook this type structure, right? Or here, this type of structure. So it always in a parallel arrangement, arranged in a parallel. So what are these functions? It dispatches the various target. It passes, transport the various materials. And second one is, it is storage. It has stored some materials or substance matter. So they had two functions. What is this? It dispatches the various target materials and stores the target material. Next, sometimes the Golgi apparatus have a sugar. It converts the complex sugar into the simple one. So the sugar, sometimes the Golgi apparatus contains sugar. It converted as a simple one. So this is the Golgi apparatus and its function. Next, move on the lysosomes. So I explain only important things. You learn your textbook. They give detailly. Later on we will discuss. If you have any doubt, later we will discuss. So lysosome. The lysosome, what is it? The waste disposal system of a cell. The waste disposal system of a cell. The name indicated waste. So any waste materials or any waste substance which are present in the cell, it can be disposal. It can be disposed through a this lysosome part. So it break down the complex material. So it also, what is another function? It break down the complex materials. So next, when cell is damaged some particular reason, what happens? That time when cell is damaged, the lysosome is burst. It burst. It start to burst. So lysosome is called as a suicide bags. This is very important. Why lysosome is called as a suicide bags? Because when the cell is damaged due to some microbial activities or other some example is when cell is damaged like disturbance of the metabolism, or cell is damaged due to some activity. So that time what happened? That time lysosome is burst, right? So that's what we become. This is called as a suicide bags. So what is this function? It wasted disposal system of a cell. It removes the waste particles in the cell. So this is the third one. First one is endoplasmic reticulum, then Golgi apparatus, then third one is the lysosome. Next, move on the mitochondria. It's very important. The structure of mitochondria is like this. Sometimes a rough sketch. We will study later in a higher class what is how structure of mitochondria. So name indicates mitochondria. It is a powerhouse. It is called as a powerhouse. So why it's called as a powerhouse? Because the mitochondria provide energy. So it manufacture the energy to whole cell. So energy produced by mitochondria, so this is called as power cell. When how it producing power or energy? Due to chemical reaction. It releases ATP. ATP means adrenosine triphosphate. It is one of energy format. It really due to chemical reaction, it releases ATP, adrenosine triphosphate. What happened? So ATP is an energy currency cell. So it is an energy giver. Which one? ATP. Right. So mitochondria is called as a powerhouse. Due to chemical reaction, the mitochondria provided ATP, adenosine triphosphate, which is an energy currency cell. So they are called as a power cell. What happened? I've written as a two membrane. That means the mitochondria contains two membranes. Then one is inside and the other one is outside. What happened? Inside of the pores have only one layer, but outside contains so many pores are there. Outside contains like this like structure. These are so many pores are there. So it helps fold ATP. What happened? The inside of the mitochondria help to fold ATP. ATP means adenosine triphosphate. Why it folds? Because to get a large surface area to place in so many ATP in the mitochondria. Inside of the mitochondria, ATP folds because to get a large surface area to fill up the more and more adenosine triphosphate. So this is about the mitochondria. Next, last is a plasticide. Plastids. What is this? Plastids. Where it locate? The plastids is locating in plant cell. Where it locate? It located in a plant cell. What happened? The plastids have two types. First one is a chromoplast. Which means the chromoplast means it's a colored plastids because it contains like a chlorophyll pigment. What do you mean chlorophyll pigment? Have you heard the chlorophyll? Yeah. We use the chlorophyll in a photosynthesis process, right, to produce a food. So chloroplast in a plant cell, then it becomes a containing chlorophyll pigment. It is a colored. It is colored. But another one, second one is a leoplast. What is this leoplast? What happened? This leoplast is colorless. Its primary organelles like starch are located. It contains a primary organelles are small components of cells. It like a starch. It colorless. Leoplast is colorless. Then stoma. There is one stoma in plastocytes. What is stoma? Stoma is a numerous layer embedded in a materials. What is that? Stoma means there is a numerous layer in embedded by a material. Such layer is called as a stoma. So these are the parts of the animal cell and plant cell. The last one is a vacuoles. Vacuoles. Vacuoles means is it have large small type of structure which are located in more and more in animal cell as well as a plant cell. So adu animal cell matu plant cell kuda kaanutade. What do you mean vacuoles? The vacuole is a storage sac for in a liquid or solid. L matu s andre liquid or solid. What do you mean vacuoles? Vacuoles is storage sac. The storage capacity of for a liquids or any solids. What happened? It contains vacuoles storage amino acid. It's one of the one protein synthesis and sugar etc. So it stores the amino acids, sugar etc. What are cell? In case of a single cell, a cell means single cell is amoeba. The food is consumed through a vacuoles. Have you know this? I explained in last. You studied detail in higher class. The amoeba has a single cell. When its food is here, after some times, it creates a vacuole. It creates a vacuole structure. See, it covers the. This is food. This is amoeba. This is food. This is amoeba. So it creates a vacuole for food consuming. Right, so vacuole is very important in a single cell because they have a no particular system to gain a food. So in unicell, it excess of water materials are expelled. In unicellular system, the vacuole helps to expel, remove excess of water or material. So it's a one of the important thing of the vacuole in the cell systems. So in this class, we studied cytoplasm. Then cell organelles, under the cell organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, then Golgi apparatus, then lysosomes, mitochondria, plasticines and vacuoles. These are very important. They will ask questions about these parts. You should learn. So this is end of this chapter, the fundamental unit of life. Next class study some another topic. Thank you.